I was very inspired by Laurie Marie's October Challenge to make an October Coptic bound book, but I cannot just make something without a story I'm telling myself. So I decided not to do the October Challenge, but to use her inspiration to make my own book. And it is the I Love You Me book. And it symbolizes what I think about love, what I think it should be, where it should go, how I should look at it and maybe feel it, I don't know. But it's a love book. And that's why it's green. So I didn't stop at just putting down the underpants. I also used green watercolor and lots of green throughout the book. I started out wanting to use the loose cardboard panels that she used and then stitch them together with the Coptic binding. But I found this really cute little book. It's really small and it called to me. So we start out with the cover, and the cover has a little box with green love potion in it. I made the green stuff with sugar and some food coloring. And there is a little bride inside and a little picture of two flying birds. This would be me, a little bell, and a diamond that's me inside. And on the cover I stamped I Love You Me. And it's covered with a kind of shiny fabric. We call it organza. This is the second page. I love this. The two circus people, men and women, going back and forth, dancing their men and women dance, or women and women, or men or men, I do not know or do not care. So there is swinging back and forth. This is a female symbol, and if you look closely, you can recognize this symbol. There's a lot of women standing in a circle, so that's the community sense, that we do it for each other and with each other sense. And this is more male, more of an challenging, competing. It's a more intense, perhaps, energy. And then we have some apples for wisdom. The book is green, by the way, because I believe the color of love is green. The color of passion is red, but the color of love is green, because nature is green, and nature is very nurturing and giving and is always there for us if we take good care of it. That's why it's green. The second page, I believe that we should love ourselves. So we should give love to ourselves. And if we start doing that, the rest will follow. But that should not be why you love yourself, so that you can get the love that you wish. Just love yourself because you're worth it. So there's a love shock. There's a lamp to guide the way. And this is a little girl, the little girl inside of me, who is offering me this. But I have to take action, so I have to try and express that love without fear of being rejected. There's a happiness Buddha, and this is a little text. Now to put on my glasses and see if I can read it. It's in Dutch. Everybody has something special inside of them that is not to be found in anyone else. It's your job to find it in life. I really, really, really love that text. I did not love the process of putting these in. I forgot what they're called, scharnieren, hinges. Because Laurie Marie glued them down, I believe, with tacky glue. And I do have a tacky glue. But they kind of came off right away. So I had to find the right screws. And I didn't have the right screws that would fit them. And then I did find them, but they were too long. And then I had to put in a lot of effort to cut them down to size. Then they fell out again. So I had to put in some tacky glue so they would stay in place. But in the end, I'm satisfied. I'm not sure if I'm doing it again. And I maybe have wasted some money ordering them online. They're on their way to me right now, but we'll see. Next page. These are the glasses of a slide projection thingy. I do not know what it's called. Diaz. I found them at a thrift store, took them out, and made little windows out of them. Love is not always happiness. So we cry, we despair. But we create our unhappiness ourselves, I think. That's why I put in a fingerprint. Because we have thoughts and expectations and ideas. And we do not check if they're reality. We just wish them to be true. And then sometimes they don't turn out to be true. So we're responsible for our own feelings regarding love and everything that hurt us when we were in love or falling out of love. There's also a really sexy nun standing there. And I really liked her. I could identify myself with her. It's not like I'm a nun, not at all. But I have this pure spiritual side of me that wants to come outside and comes out while making my art, but I don't share it with too many people. And she has on very sexy shoes. So that's me too. Here it says I'm enough, and here it says alles is liefde, which means everything is love. Everything, even the tears you cry. Next page, we can see her eyes again, we can see the nun. We also like to have sex, I think, as adults, most of us probably. And sex is also a very important part of love, so it deserved a place in this book. And I put the Om sign because the Om sign is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. So the beginning and the end, it starts with love and ends with love, I believe. And here we have my queen. I like this image. I've used it many times. I bought some magazines at a thrift store, and I think I bought three of the same kind. So I found this picture again and again and again, and I loved it. So she's the alchemist. She knows that happiness is found inside, but she needs to be balanced. She needs to love herself, and then she can control her world. I'm a Pisces, so in most of my work, you'll find some kind of Pisces sign or fish floating around. And then we have the little girl inside. So this is she, and she is she, and they symbolize me, of course. And the little girl inside needed a really nice place in this book. It says, ik ben zo blij met jou, which means I'm so happy with you. Because she took in a lot, and she had to conquer a lot to grow up to be me. And she tried her best, and I love her for that. So she symbolizes me. There is a transformational butterfly and a little candle to guide her on her way. Oh, and the drop is a symbol for her purity. And this lady, it's a yoga position which brings you back to your inner child and inner peace and inner joy. And I really would like to practice that pose, but I keep forgetting it because I fall asleep when I practice yoga or do mindfulness or meditate. Perhaps I should not be lying in my bed when I do that. Next page is a crane bird. It's also a symbol of longevity and happiness, which I really liked. And loving yourself also means going out by yourself, going out on adventures by yourself. You don't always need somebody to verify your existence, I think. And if you do that, you find the rock that is you, which is beautiful and glistening, and which is stronger and sturdier than you might think. And then this text says it's realms of possibility. You may not know what lies beyond the horizon, but therein lies the magic, says Helen Martin. I do not know who she is, but she said it, and this is the horizon, so that's where the magic is. And then I use the Dutch door, and this lady is getting an angel wash, and I like that image. There's a serenity, a contentment, which I would like to feel more. I created a pocket with a free bird and two of hearts, of course. And this, let me read it, is a Danmala. The Danmala mirrors that what we cannot express. Danmalas are unspoken love poems. I liked giving myself an unspoken love poem because I do not get many love poems, unfortunately. Which is not a hint for you, maybe for the universe. Anyway, let's continue. Then we're at the end. I like this. This is the rising phoenix, and then she rose again. So after all the heartache and the disappointments, don't think that love's not for you. Just rise again and try again, and you'll find it. And you've learned what you want to do different next time, hopefully. So it's time to rise again. I put in this little circular window, which is covered with plastic. And this is hemp thread. And I thought I made a little guitar out of it so you can make your own music. But of course that doesn't work. But it's the symbolism that counts. So make your own music, dance to your own tune, think what you want to think, believe what you want to believe, live the life you want to live, because this is the only life you get. And then we are at the end. This is the back cover. This is the hemp thread and the back of the circular window. And throughout the book you find these golden rings. It's the rings that marry me to me. I like the idea that you could marry yourself, promise to love yourself, which kind of inspired me with buying these little rings. They were 10 cents at a thrift store. So there's one as well, and throughout the book there's one or two. This is my book. I was very much inspired by Laura Marie, so I thank her for that. It's not going to be an October book, it's not going to be a Halloween book, but I am inspired to make more of these. I found another book at a mini library at our local grocery store, so now I just have to come up with a new theme. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to look at the close-ups that follow now. Bye-bye.